Anonymous attendee says, zinc of 100 of 800 and copper of 692 on the ion test, both in the low red, was taking 15 milligrams of zinc and 1 milligram of copper at the time of testing. Thoughts on what to increase the supplement level to in order to keep the correct ratio. I don't recommend looking at the zinc to copper ratio. I know that there are studies correlating health endpoints with the zinc to copper ratio, but I do not believe that it is a causal factor in disease. I believe the reason that the zinc to copper ratios are often associated with disease is because inflammation raises plasma copper and lowers plasma zinc based on taking zinc up into cells and mobilizing stored copper out of the liver. And I think you just want zinc and copper in, not the ratios, I think you want them in the right levels. And zinc at 800, if I, you know, those units are different than what I'm used to. I believe that corresponds to 80 on a typical test. At 80, you're not really deficient, but you'd probably be better off if you increased your zinc up by 10 or 20%. And your copper is, if I remember right, that's at the bottom of the range. And I really think copper, you want to be in the middle of the range. I don't think the bottom range of copper or zinc is adequate. And you know, if you're taking that supplement, the simplest thing to do would be to take it twice a day instead of once a day, and also make sure you're taking it on an empty stomach. 50 milligrams of zinc in most people will not cause nausea on an empty stomach if you take it with a full glass of water. In some people, it does. But most people, it doesn't. And if you can get away with taking it on an empty stomach, do so. And if you cannot, make sure that you are not taking it anywhere near phytate, which is found in whole grains, nuts, seeds, and legumes, and is the principal inhibitor of zinc absorption. So make sure the conditions are right. If the conditions are right, double the dose, check it again, triple the dose, check it again. Yeah, I know the units are ppb, Doug. I know they are. I'm just saying, if I remember correctly, the ppb on the ion converts to divided by 10 for the typical units. So so anyway, make sure the supplement's taken correctly, double it or triple it and see what happens. Probably you need more copper from another source. I'm a bit like, when I recommend Gero Zinc Balance, which has that exact ratio that you're talking about, maybe that's what you're taking, I recommend that for a zinc supplement, not for a copper supplement. And I just think it's a convenient way to have the copper in there in a way that makes the zinc safe without causing a deficiency. If someone is deficient in copper, that's not an adequate source of copper for two reasons. One, the copper amount is too low. And two, the form of copper in all copper supplements, almost all copper supplements, is wrong. It's not the oxidation state that you get in food, and there's evidence in animal experiments that it's lower bioavailability. So for a copper supplement, I would want to see food first, and if you want a supplement, I would supplement with liver capsules, because liver capsule, you know, so Ancestral, it doesn't have to be that brand, but Ancestral liver capsules at 6 a day are going to provide a very significant amount of copper, and it will be in the food form. Same thing if you were taking Oyster Max oyster capsules, this for zinc and copper. Like, the amount is kind of low in those, but you keep taking them and you will get a significant amount of copper in the right form. And then for foods, you know, check out the tiers of copper-rich foods that I recommend. So liver, cocoa powder, certain mushrooms. I'll put a link in the show notes to where I've laid out those copper-rich foods.